Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to talk about microwave links technology and their different types, and the video is important for fresh graduates or for anyone needs basic information for any interview. But first, we should know what is the meaning of microwave link. A microwave link is a communication system that uses a beam of radio waves in the microwave frequency range to transmit video, audio or data between two locations, which can be from a few meters to several kilometers long. Okay, now there are different types of microwave links. First, the widely common use is a traditional microwave link or the split mount. And in this type, link installed using microwave dish antenna, RAUs, IF cables, and IDUs. And I will explain all these types in this video. The second type is the full outdoor microwave link, and in this type, link installed with only dish antennas and RAUs and no need for IF cables or IDU unit. While the third type is MBL microwave link or multiband link. This microwave link uses a combination between traditional node and full outdoor unit, where link installed using dish antennas, IF cables, IDUs, RAUs, and also full outdoor RAU. Let's start with the traditional node, where this link can be configured with different ways. It can be configured as 1+0, 1+1HS, 1+1FD, or XPIC. For the microwave link that configured to be 1+0, in this type, the microwave link installed only with one RAU from each site to carry all the traffic, and the link uses one IF cable and one IDU from each site. Although this type is easy for installation, but its major disadvantage is that if any failure takes place at any RAU from site or facing, all traffic will be affected as no backup exists. So, to overcome this problem of protection, the solution was the configuration of 1+1HS, which stands for Hot Standby. And in this type, link will be installed by using two RAUs from both sites, and one microwave dish from each site, and a single polarized coupler, and also one IDU unit, of course from each site. However, two RAUs and two IF cables installed, but only one RAU work and the other RAU is standby. So it seems like 1+0 but protected. They have the same capacity, 1+0 and 1+1HS have the same capacity. So if any failure takes place at the main RAU, the traffic will not be affected, because the standby RAU will take the role and become the main RAU, and the traffic will not be affected. Another configuration type is 1+1FD, which stands for frequency diversity. This type of configuration is not commonly used nowadays, because the link will be configured with two frequencies, and this is not recommended from mobile operators, because the operator will have to pay more for two frequencies, not only one. This type can be used for the microwave link that serve a VIP site, because if any external interference affected one frequency and cause any disturbance in the branch, so the other frequency will work normally, because the other branch has a different frequency, so no traffic can be affected. But as I say, this is an expensive solution because of working with two different frequencies. The frequency diversity solution will take us to the XPIC configuration, which is commonly used nowadays. XPIC stands for Cross Polarization Interference Cancellation, and in this type, the link configured with different configurations like 2+0, 2+2, 4+0. We will talk now at the common configuration, which is 2+0. In XPIC 2+0, the link uses two RAUs from both sites and one microwave dish and a dual polarized coupler from each site. XPIC uses only one frequency for both branches, but for branch A, the IDU sends the signal over a vertical polarization, while the other branch sends the signal over horizontal branch. Keep in mind that both branches V and H are working at the same time, so the capacity of sending data doubled, and this feature is crucial because of doubling the traffic with only one frequency. In my opinion, XPIC is the best solution because link is protected and capacity increased with only one frequency, so the cost will be low. Well, that's all for today's video. Follow me for the coming videos as I will explain in details how to configure microwave links for different microwave vendors like SIAE, Huawei and Ericsson, and I will show you how to configure microwave links 1+0, 1+1, and of course for E-band and MBL links.